Well, I'm in the center of Khabarovsk. What's been happening here the last 4 days is very unusual. It's also very worrying for the Kremlin because people have been taking to the streets, risking arrest, to express their anger at what's been happening here, to express their support for the regional governor, who last week was arrested, flown to Moscow, and has been accused of involvement in multiple murders, stretching back a decade and a half. And that has sparked a lot of anger here from the crowd. You can hear the cars beeping their horns in support of the protesters. Many people in Khabarovsk believe that the move against their governor is politically motivated. Now on Saturday there was a big crowd, 30,000 people turned out. It's much smaller tonight, a few hundred. But there seems to be a momentum. The protests are continuing. And there's certainly a lot of resentment here felt towards the Kremlin.
Мы все прекрасно понимаем, что у них свое государство, и им все равно на наш дальний край. Мы для них просто средство для существования.
Поддержать нашего губернатора, потому что мы его выбирали народом.
Day 5 of the protests in the Russian Far East, and this has become something of a nightly tradition in Khabarovsk. Every evening this week, protesters, around 200 people, have gathered here on Lenin Square to chant slogans in support of the regional governor, Sergei Furgal. Now, according to Russian law, this is classed as an unsanctioned protest, an illegal protest. You can see over here the police, a line of police guarding the regional administration building. But the police so far haven't made any attempt to clear the protesters from the square or to stop them marching through the city centre. And in fact, we heard some of the protesters shouting, "Thank you, police, thank you for not moving us away." It's interesting that this comes just a few days, a couple of weeks after a constitutional vote that gives Vladimir Putin the right to run for office 2 more times. The Kremlin said that that was a vote for stability, but there's little sign of stability at the moment here in Khabarovsk.